Well, I'm in Raymond, where there is definitely still a power outage, unfortunately. It's this trailer that was hit, as you can see, very hard by Sandy. A tree is still across it, but some of it actually has been cut now, the area that was tangled in power lines. But that didn't happen until today. And for the homeowner, the wait has been grueling.
But they can't cut that piece off, because if they cut that piece down,
that one's going to go right through the house.
And that's when my house is going to buckle and there's nothing left to it.
This was Deb Martin mid-afternoon, still distraught over her predicament. A tree had sliced through her trailer, and along with it came power lines. And until they were removed, she couldn't move the tree.
We can't do anything.
She took us inside. The tree could be seen protruding through the roof and into her bedroom, where her boyfriend normally would have been sleeping at that hour.
If he was sleeping, he would have been back. Well, everything would have fallen on him, probably would have been dead.
Outside, it was awfully close to her oil tank and stretched clear across the top of the trailer. She was anxiously waiting for PS&H.
We can't do anything until they come and do their job. I mean, I pay enough in electricity that. I know a lot of people without power. I'm without a home.
She got her wish. Soon after we talked, PS&H crews along with tree trimmers arrived and started to work. It was a welcome sight for Deb, who just wants to get her life back to normal again.
Now, the trailer park manager is supposed to bring in her own tree crew tomorrow, now that the lines have been taken off of the trailer and she can get to work removing it completely. But right now, no word on when the power will be restored. Reporting live in Raymond, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.